Hello everyone, this is Monica Lupion, and today I will solve the example included in the lecture 11, Differential Equation of Mass Transfer. This is part of the online course CE318 Heat Mass Transfer. First, a quick review of the equations that we covered so far. The general equation of mass transfer is indicated here. We cover this equation on lecture 11, and it says that the variation in the molar flux plus the variation in the concentration with time minus the variation due to the chemical reaction is equal to zero. We can combine that general equation of mass transfer with the Fick rate equation that we covered in lecture 10. Where the molar flux was a composition of the molar flux due to the diffusivity, so the molecular diffusion, plus the mass transfer due to the bulk motion. If we combine these two, this general equation and the Fick rate equation, and we apply certain assumptions in order to simplify the differential equation plus the application of the boundary conditions and the initial conditions, we can finally solve the system and calculate the molar flux of the mass transfer. This is the example that I will be solving today. Please stop your video for a few minutes, read through the example, and make sure you understand everything. Consider a single porous spherical inert mineral particle. The pores inside the particle are filled with liquid water, which is the species number B. We are interested in analyzing the molecular diffusion of the contaminant benzene, that's the element A, within the water-filled pores of the particle. Benzene is very soluble in water and does not absorb onto the intersurfaces of the pores. The process is isothermal at 298 Kelvin. The concentration of dissolved benzene in the water surrounding the particle is constant with time. Starting with the general differential equation for mass transfer, develop a differential model to describe the concentration profile of benzene within the single porous spherical inert mineral particle. State reasonable assumptions on boundary and initial conditions. The effective diffusion coefficient of benzene in the water-filled pores of the particle is represented by the term DAE, the diffusivity, the molecular diffusion coefficient. Okay, so first of all, we need to make some assumptions. The first one is that this is a process that depends with time, so it's in steady state. There is no chemical reaction, so air A is equal to zero. We can consider that it's a dilute system, so the concentration of benzene is very small. So the amount of benzene present, it's small compared to the amount of water. And finally, it's a one-dimension flux along R, which is spherical coordinates. As we just review a few minutes ago, we have to combine two different equations in order to solve the system. One is the general equation of mass conservation. It's indicated here. And second is the Fick rate equation. In this case, let's see how the assumptions apply to these two equations. There is no chemical reaction, so this coefficient RA is equal to zero. And secondly, it's a dilute system, so the concentration of benzene is very small. We can consider that it's close to zero, so this term here will also cancel. The mass conservation equation is in spherical coordinates and is expressed here in this line, as we studied in lecture 11. In this particular case, it's one dimension, so the flux only changes within the air coordinates, so these two terms here can be cancelled. On the other hand, since it's a dilute system, the peak rate equation can be also simplified, and it takes this form here. If we combine these two equations, the mass conservation equation and the peak rate equation, basically what we do is to include this molar flux of air of A here in this first equation. This is what we can get. So it's a dependence with R and also dependence with the time. And we play around with this equation here, and this is the final expression where we can relate the concentration, the variation of the concentration of benzene with time, with the variation of concentration along the coordinate R, and also take into consideration the molecular diffusion coefficient. The next step will be to specify the inertial conditions and the van der Waals conditions, and these can be tricky sometimes. Initial conditions are normally easier than the van der Waals conditions. In this case, when the time is zero at the beginning of the process, the concentration of benzene in the water is zero. So there is no mass transfer happening yet. So the benzene hasn't gone through the water yet. As for the van der Waals conditions, if you remember from lecture 11, we indicated that when there is a certain line of asymmetry, we can assume that the variation of the concentration with the coordinate R at the center line of symmetry is equal to zero. The second boundary condition is related to the surface of this particle, the spherical particle. So over the surface, the concentration is constant with time. That is something that is stated in the problem, and is equal to this value, the concentration of A over the surface. And that will be it. If you have any questions, please contact me. Thank you.